In this video, we will take a brief look at the human digestive system. The function of our digestive system is to digest the food that we consume. Now, what do we mean by digest? Digest means to break down food into smaller substances that can be absorbed and used by our cells. This process is not simple, as we often consume complex large molecules in large chunks, and that's probably why our gastrointestinal tract is 30 feet long. The GI tract consists of 7 main sites, which are the oral cavity, the pharynx, the esophagus, the stomach, the small intestine, and the large intestine. As you might have guessed, this is in order through which the food travels down our body. Let's start from the top, at the oral cavity. The oral cavity is nothing but a fancy name for our mouth. The mouth is the first of digestion, where both mechanical and chemical digestion occurs. Mechanical digestion is the physical breakdown of large food chunks into smaller ones, whereas chemical digestion refers to the chemical breakdown of complex macromolecules into smaller digestible molecules. In the mouth, mechanical digestion, as you would have guessed, is the movement, chewing. Our mouth makes us use the accessory organ, teeth, here. We humans have various types of teeth that allows us to break down large pieces of food into smaller ones, which allows for easy movement down the throat and better absorption by increasing its surface area. Chemical digestion in the mouth is carried out by the saliva. The accessory organ of salivary glands located in our mouth secrete saliva, an extracellular fluid that is mostly made up of water. Saliva also contains an important enzyme known as amylase. Amylase is an enzyme that is used to break down large carbohydrate molecules into smaller maltose molecules, which is a disaccharide of carbohydrates. A disaccharide is a much smaller molecule, but it is not the simplest sugar, as it can be broken down further into monosaccharides, which happens later at the intestine. The resultant of the mechanical and chemical digestion at the mouth is known as the bolus. Bolus is basically a small, round mass of the partially digested food. The bolus, when swallowed, moves into the pharynx, a hollow tube that starts behind the nose and ends at the top of the trachea and esophagus. The bolus travels down the pharynx to enter the esophagus, a small muscular tube that connects the pharynx to the stomach. The food travels down the muscular esophagus with the help of a process known as peristalsis. Peristalsis is the involuntary contraction and relaxation of circular muscles that allow the bolus to smoothly travel down to the stomach. In the stomach, again, occurs both chemical and physical digestion. Physical, from the muscular contractions of the stomach walls, which breaks down the food, and chemical, from the gastric juice containing HCl and pepsinogen. The HCl is released by parietal cells of the stomach lining, while the pepsinogen is released by the chief cells. HCl is very acidic, as it has a pH ranging from 1.5 to 3.5 in the stomach. The acid environment created helps kill most of the bacteria present in the food, which helps in avoiding many infections. The acidic medium also causes the proteins present in the food to denature, causing them to uncoil, which exposes their structure by creating larger surface area. The acidic environment also triggers the conversion of pepsinogen to pepsin. Pepsin is an enzyme that breaks down protein into smaller polypeptides. Polypeptides are nothing but a smaller protein chain that is made of less amino acids. This digestion causes the bolus to become into pulpy acidic fluid called chyme. At the end of digestion in the stomach, the gastric mucosa, a layer of mucous membrane present in the stomach, releases bicarbonate, Bicarbonate is a base, so it helps in neutralizing the HCl of the chyme and reducing the pH to some extent in preparation for the small intestine. You might be wondering, how does the stomach protect itself from this acid? It is with the help of the mucose bicarbonate barrier present on the entire surface of the gastric mucosa. This layer is insoluble and contains bicarbonate, which neutralizes the acid so it does not allow the acid to damage the stomach cells. The chyme from the stomach is slowly released into the small intestine in small quantities, which is controlled by the pyloric sphincter. The pyloric sphincter opens and allows for a small amount of chyme to pass into the duodenum of the small intestine. As the duodenum fills, it puts pressure on the pyloric sphincter, causing it to close. This process of slow secretion of chyme is crucial because chyme is a hypertonic solution, which means it has a high solute concentration. So when it enters the duodenum, it creates a water potential, which causes water from the blood capillaries to enter the small intestine. So if all the chyme is released at once, the blood volume will reduce drastically, which can be life-threatening. This is a long process, so the rest of the video, which is the small and large intestine, will be covered in another video. To conclude, in this video, we have looked at ingestion, propulsion, mechanical breakdown, and digestion. Ingestion was the consumption of food through the mouth. Propulsion was the movement of bolus in the esophagus. And finally, mechanical and chemical digestion occurred in the stomach and in the mouth. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you in the next one.